Silva, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to be teaching you how to do your own DIY gel nails at home. So before you start anything, wash your hands. Next, I'm going to be applying a little bit of cuticle cream. I love this stuff. It's from Sally's Beauty. It's not too expensive either. Just take a little bit and dabble it all over your nails, and then in 5 or 10 minutes, you just let it soak on your nails, and then it just softens your cuticles, and you can just push them back without any pain. And I honestly love this stuff. I didn't even know it was a thing until I watched a couple YouTube videos online, and I absolutely love this stuff. Next, you just want to take a little tool. I got this one from Sally's as well, and just push back your cuticles. Don't be too rough or too like aggressive when doing this step. Just be super, super chill and just push them back, and yeah, just push back your cuticles. Next, I am using this cuticle trimmer. I got this one from Winners and it was super inexpensive. Any cuticle trimmer will work. Lightly just trim around your cuticles, any skin that you have around your nails. Be very, very gentle with this step. I have cut myself so many times, and super, super deep cuts close to your nail makes it super hard to paint. Just be super gentle when cutting around your cuticles. Next, after I trim my cuticles, once I have the cuticle softener up, I like to wash my hands just to get them fresh for painting. After you wash your hands, you're gonna wanna take a little bit of rubbing alcohol and just with a little cotton pad and rub all the grease, dirt, anything that remains on your nails. You just wanna get all that off and have a fresh canvas for painting. Next, I'm gonna be doing my base coat. I have used these two brands that I got from Amazon. They both work just as well. I prefer the one that I'm using in this video. It dries soft without a tacky feeling, and it just is easier to apply your nail polish. So when doing your nail polish, you want to apply thin, even coats. I like to do 3 to 4 coats, depending how opaque you like it. I today did 3 or 4, and honestly, I love the way it looks. It just has a lot of color, and when you're using glitter, it's essential to make sure you're getting glitter on every single crevice, or you could definitely miss some spots and it would look disgusting. Next, you want to use a no wipe top coat, and this is essential when you're doing your nails, because usually when you do a top coat, it leaves a sticky residue and it does not come off. But if you get a no wipe top coat, you can just paint it with a top coat, put it in the LED, and you'll be good right after. And you can just wash your hands or do whatever you want, eat, and your nails are completely cured and you don't have to wipe them at all. The last step is a lotion. Of course, you're gonna want some lotion after you do your nails. Using all these products and the rubbing alcohol and cutting and everything really dries out your hands, so it's essential to re-moisturize them. So that is how I do my DIY gel nails at home. I really hope you guys enjoyed. As usual, all my social media is linked down below, and I'll see you guys in the next video.